couldn't do that. It was a stretch for her to fix these cinnamon rolls.
Yeah, I think she.
But she wasn't
still
feeling right.
Weather had been fairly cool, so
she was living by herself. It was after she had lived with us for a while.
Yeah,
she started
still
over
it.
So she wasn't feeling like baking, but she wanted to be with us, so she decided to fix her special cinnamon rolls.
I didn't
want to. No, she didn't. Maybe Sue.
I don't think we ever told her the truth.
Oh, she's trying to tell
what? Anyway, right at the last, I got her cinnamon rolls. She worked and fixed them up beautifully, and two big trays of them. And we thought we were going to take that red probe, and at the last minute we decided to take
it.
I guess the
you had a flat, I thought, or something.
No. Anyway, so I had the red probe all packed with the cinnamon rolls, and at the last minute we took a different car, and we were clear almost to St. Louis before I realized we didn't have those cinnamon rolls.
You're coming here?
And it just made me sick. You know, it's too far to come back. So we went on. I kept worrying, what do we tell Mother about the cinnamon rolls? Because she's going to expect us to brag about those cinnamon rolls. And I can't remember what we said, but we didn't tell her.
I think it was Thanksgiving.
Your cinnamon rolls are always good or something like that. But anyway, Thanksgiving then, she was at our house.
No,
Christmas.
Yeah.
Month later.
Anyway, when I got home, I took those cinnamon rolls and put them in the freezer.
But it was cold outside, too.
Yeah, it was cold.
In November.
But then at Christmas time, I had everything, and I brought those cinnamon rolls out. And she said, these cinnamon rolls just aren't as good as mine, are they? And she said, where'd you get these? I think I said, well, little girl at school gave them to me.
Really? I didn't know you said that.
Well, yeah, I think I did.
You really stretched it, Lois.
Well, I could not tell her. Well, I don't think we ever did tell her.
She would have been so.
I mean, you know, I just felt terrible. And she went to so much work.
Oh, of course.
Her cinnamon rolls were always wonderful, but
those might not after her. Left in the car, and probably it got hot every day because, you know, cars, even in the winter, it's sunny.
Yeah. Bless her heart. Let me tell you another story about Mother Schmidt. When David and Leah got married.
No, I was listening to the story.
When David and Leah got married, Mother and Daddy came, and Mother was still in her prime making cinnamon rolls, and so for the reception at the dinner. The husband's parents were supposed to provide something. She fixed the rolls, and they got there and they put them up on top of the freezer. We had this big, big freezer. And
the one that was in the room at Kearney?
No, they came to our house in Joplin. And it was in the garage, and so David had put Bear, the dog that and had Bear in the garage too. Well, Bear is a jumper, you know, that kind of dog. Bear, the rolls had not risen. They were in the process. So for that night, Bear jumped up there and ate. I don't know how many. I think there were a couple of trays. And they still had not risen.
I'm going to change.
And that dog, David had to, the day of his wedding reception, he had to take his dog to the vet. And they gave him, was it mineral oil or castor oil?
I don't know what his stomach was like.
I mean,
it was rising inside him.
Oh, yes.
Could have killed him.
He thought it was going to kill him. So that was another story.
That's a good one, too.
And she was so sad because she'd worked so hard for this
Yeah.
Reception dinner.
Here's
Oh, mercy. But Mother's rolls were always so good. And Sue, I'm sorry. Your rolls are just as good.
Well, thank you.
That makes me feel good. They're as good as Grandma's. Cute as Mother's.
Bear would have loved them.
Bear would have loved these, huh? Well, Suzanne makes good rolls. I've been trying. She's got it down.
Jason told me I had to learn so I could teach Meg.
Oh, okay. That's good. Keep it in the family. Mm-hmm.
She does it good. She made them for, didn't you make them for Thanksgiving?
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, everybody loved them then.
Who did you have at your house for Thanksgiving?
Several of her friends.
Mm-hmm. And you've kind of got
it's amazing what they can do these days, isn't it?
Always put on there.
That's the hard.
How did you do that? Now, You're getting there.
More brown sugar in it.
This is actually this is an old camera now.
Well, you know, I read a tip
on my molasses jar the other day. It said if you want to make brown sugar, and I wonder if Mother didn't put a touch of molasses in her.
Wow, that'd be good. She never told us that secret.
Well, see, she really didn't have us help her
in the kitchen
and you know and tell us all this stuff. I had to watch from a distance, but.
She, I think, might have put more brown sugar in it than I do. I think I put 1 cup of brown sugar to 2 cups of powdered sugar.
And her sugar was a little darker.
I think that's it. Or maybe she used dark brown and I just had the light brown.
I bet she used
dark brown.
I like dark
brown. She used platter flavoring, too.
That's right. She liked it. Use platter flavoring. Butter flavoring.
She would sit down and listen and write.
Do you know what? One thing I discovered when I wasn't making mine very good, I watched her again more carefully. When she made her cinnamon roll, she'd roll it out as big as she could, and then she ladened that with margarine. I mean butter, margarine I think is what she used. I mean it was totally all over it. And then she sprinkled cinnamon on it and brown sugar.
Lots of sugar.
White sugar. No, brown sugar. Brown sugar. And then of course you roll them up and cut them and later you ice them. You don't ice them until you're ready to serve them after they're baked. But she did put so much more butter in. Once I started putting more butter
in. I think so.
But you just need to put that much in it. You know how rich it is.
I'm not sitting there.
Okay. Cosette, your bread's really good. I had some of that too.
What do you call this? What was it, swine?
Nablog.
She made that up, she said.
Nablog.
You made this up?
Well, I made one following a recipe for our friends from Korea. Just to have some traditional something, and it turned out really heavy, like we made like a ton, like, and I was worried it wasn't good, so I took my banana bread recipe and just followed it sort of, and then added eggnog stuff to it.
Wow!
And then the icing was supposed to be eggnog candy, but it didn't turn out, so I just used it.
So you did you squash?
It was supposed to be candy.
It was supposed to be like candy, but it didn't work right. I was gonna make it into like a bar, but it didn't get like solid.
It's delicious on this bread.
Good stuff.
You like this bread.
Charlie, you look so cute in your scarf and everything.
I made my scarf.
You made it? Oh, that's perfect.
How did you see it?
Did you make yourself one too? This is perfect for you too, I'm sure. It is gorgeous.
I love it. I wear it. It matches so many of my things.
It is so lovely. It's so soft. It's like it's a heather.
Heather like soft.
Cutest. Really nice. Oh, how do you? You just wrap it?
It's really nice and long and thin, so you can do a lot of fun stuff with it. So I like.
I just saw the red hairs on the side, and I thought you would have had some extensions in.
You give me a lot of credit.
I love the way that the tassel, when you did the end of it,
Where'd you get that?
She made it.
Cosette made it.
That means for all the stories.
She made it for her birthday.
Would you want to feed her, Mom?
They learned how to crochet in
4-H.
Do you want me to feed her, Mom?
I'm fine with it.
They learned how to crochet in 4-H.
I'm not eating that much.